increases day by day by regions, and they go in pairs this time. The first two belong to one set, and the next two also to a set divided. Helmut and Deluc de Saint-Denis-Nechel are two or four pieces that are called four identical pieces, and I think when you hear them, you'll realize why. But regards the title, it's really interesting. I was asked, this is also really written for people. I was asked, Richard Ayres was also invited at that time, to write pieces for a festival in Bratislava. And I had been asked by John Snyders of Amsterdam to write a piece for him based on Carmen. And I said, yes, I'd be glad to. Lovely idea, yes, hello. And he asked me about a year or two later, and I said, yes, I'm still thinking about it. I really want to do it. And then my friend Daniel Mate in Bratislava said, would you write a piece based on Satie's three pieces in the form of a pair? I said, yes, sounds like a good idea. Then I thought, isn't it funny? Aki Takahashi was going around asking people to write pieces based on the Beatles. And Ivan Mikhashov, bless his soul, was asking people to write pieces in the form of a tango. So I thought, why didn't I actually get around to doing this piece finally and do one piece to serve all purposes? And even though Aki and Ivar never asked me, I thought I'd make one piece before. And the piece Helmut was performed in Bratislava by John Tilbury. I call it, with a French subtitle, Helmut, and then it goes on, Un morceau lourd en forme de poire. And those of you who might know the giant country to the east, but there's a chancellor there who has a head in the shape of hair. And he is a very heavy piece, as one might say. So that's the reason for that title. And Deluc de Saint-Denis-Nechel, nudes descending a ladder, but this could be, of course, a tone ladder, it could be a scale in this case. Actually, Carmen and Michel of the Beatles. So if you listen carefully, you'll hear both of them in there. In addition to Satie, whom I don't care for very much, I must say, so I dispense with him after about three bars. The next two pieces, L'Orchidée d'Argent and Pandora, belong to a large orchestra piece called Orchidée or the Nage, which I composed in 1989, performed in Donau Eschingen. And, Pandora is a kind of Pandora's box. It opens itself to all kinds of possibilities, all kinds of contrasts. A rather rough piece in a certain way, isn't it? Gentle, full of contrasts. And L'Orchidée d'Argent, well, actually, you could call it the silver orchid, but you could also call it the money orchid. And this whole piece, Orchidée Ordinaire, is about the composer's hunger for money. So much for that, and I'll ask Deborah again, you could take it away.
Thank you.
actually a piece which departs from the others in a certain sense. We come back to the keynote history. It's not a piece of mine basically over the last 10 years. And it's not been performed yet. So this is the very first airing of it. Yet, its first performance is scheduled for next Sunday in Munich. So if you don't get anywhere, you're going to hear it here now. It's a piece which is, it takes the form of a piano concerto and was mainly composed in the years 61 and 63, well, 61 to 63. After carrying it around in my head for many, many years, I finally notated it in 75, but there was a part missing. And this part, which I hadn't finished in 61, 63, or in 75, I finally got to grips with last year and finished it on the 21st of March, so very recently. So if everything works, I'll need a little time to start for the equipment. We're hearing the demo version. It's a piece for piano and orchestra. But here we hear a set of sound modules for the instruments. And the piano itself, I think it has it like that. So we'll be playing the piano part. The subtitle, "Au fin du quelque siècle," means at the turn of some centuries. Four minutes.